are you ready to take part in the most thrilling bidding experiences online? Want to say goodbye to the traditional website auction? Look no further. Hi, I am Nishtha, and today we're going to introduce you to Odoo website auction. It is here to transform the way you manage your auctions. With an easy-to-use interface and a wide range of categories, the Odoo website auction provides a centralized platform for the buyers to take part in the bidding. The Odoo website auctions allows you to list your product effortlessly, complete with descriptions, images, and even bidding initial prices. Once the auction begins, users can participate in real-time bidding, allowing them to place bids in the current bid, track their progress, and get an instant notification when outbid. Now let's give it a trial to the workflow. But before that, make sure to subscribe to our channel and tap the notification bell to stay updated with the latest content. Apart from this, I would like to mention that if you need extensions for increasing the sales of your e-commerce store, then you can visit store.webkul.com and explore a number of products for every technology. We also have the user guide for the same in our blog sections, from where you can check the features and configuration and get to know the functionality of the extensions as well. Now let's move back to our video. Now as you can see, we are on the Odoo backend panel, and with the help of email and the password, we're going to log in. Click on login. Here on the left hand side, you can see the home menu is there. Click on this and then navigate towards the settings option. In the settings option, you have to click on this website Webkul add-ons. And here by scrolling down, you can see the option of website auction. It will going to appear here as a configuration once you will going to add it to your Odoo panel. Otherwise, it won't reflect. I have already added, that's why it is showing configuration. So we'll click on this configuration, and from the configuration, I will configure the points which I want to reflect on my storefront, or how I want to reflect my storefront to my customers. So as per your requirement, you can manage those options from here. Like the first one is website published information. The next one is expired notification, notify auto bidder, miscellaneous settings, and the notify subscriber. From these checkboxes, you can just use those information or use those options which you want to show to your storefront to your customers. And now let me show you some more features of auction. So for that, we'll navigate towards our home menu again and we'll click on this website. Here you can see the option of auction. Click on this, and the first one is working auction. In the working auction, you can see the list of the auctions which are in working state. Right now there is no auction because I haven't created any of the auctions. The next one is completed auction. In the completed auction, you can see the list of the auctions which are completed. As you can see, there are the auctions which are showing completed, and you can check the details as well from here. The next is auction subscriber. Auction subscribers are basically the consumers which have subscribed for your auction. That means they can get the notification for the expiration of the auction, for a new bidding, or for the bidding amount which have been raised by the bidders. And if the subscriber want, they can jump in between the auction and can take part in the auction as well. The next one is increment rule. Increment rule is basically the amount which you can add to your auction. For example, the auction is reached a certain amount, and you want that if the auction is from this to this amount, raising more than that, so you can add a auto increment amount for the same. As you can see, I have already created some of the increment rules. So from here, these are the options which are going to reflect on the storefront. And if the amount is raising the particular amount, the bidding amount, so it will going to increase the initial bidding amount from that particular increment. The next one is auction bidders. Here you can see the bidders details, like who have placed the bidding amount for the auction. Now let me show you how you can create an auction. So for that, we'll click on this auction and then navigate towards the working auction and click on new. So from here, you can just create a new auction for any of the amount you want. I mean any of the product you want. Now we'll choose the bidding rules. So we'll select all the bidding rules and click on the select option. Now you can configure the timings, like when you want to start the auction and when you want to end the auction. So we're going to select the timing for the same and the ending timing as well. Now we'll click on this save option, and after clicking on save option you need to click on this confirmed auction. So once you click on this confirmed auction, the auction is automatically saved. And for example, you want to run the auction immediately, so you can just click on this run auction and the auction will start at the same time whenever you click on this run auction from the backend panel, and this the admin can only do from the backend panel. Click on this run auction and you can see the options are changes. That means you can also extend this auction if you want, and you can also complete the auction, you can also close the auction by just clicking on these options. Now let me show you how it will going to reflect on the storefront. So for that, we'll navigate towards the site option and click on this home page. Here under this home page you can see the option of auction. In this auction you can see those products which are right now on the auction. So you can see there are two products which are right now on the auction, and this we have just added. So we'll open this. Here are the details that at what time it had started and it in how much time it will going to end. So from here you can check those, and this is the bidding amount, like bidders list. From here you can check that how much bidders are there. Right now there are no bidders, that's why it's showing zero bids. There are two options, simple bid and auto bid. Simple bid is basically the correct exact amount which you want. You can just click on this simple bid and can add the amount. Like I want to add a particular this amount for this bidding. And the auto bid is basically the increment rule will going to apply here. Like for example, if I'm adding an amount and clicking on this place my bid, you can see the bidding amount is like automatically increased by $10 as I have added this rule from the backend. And by clicking on this bids, you can check the bidding list from here. And the next option is subscriber or unsubscribe. From this option you can subscribe, as I told you that the subscriber will get the notification of all the details of the auction. Now if you don't want to participate in the auction, so you can just click on this buy now and can purchase this product as the initial amount. Now clicking on this auction details, you can check the details of this auction, and now we'll close this amount. So let me show you how this will going to reflect on the backend, from the backend how you can check this. So we'll navigate towards this auction, and from the auction bidders we can check the details of this particular auction which we have placed right now. As you can see, there are two bidders who have placed the bidding amount for the same. See, the highest bidding is which we have placed just now. This is the highest one, and these are the initial amount which have been taken place before this final bid. So this is how you can manage the auction, and you can also check the completed auction. See, these are the completed auctions which are completed from the storefront. So like the way you can manage the auction, you can create the auction, and you can check the auction details from the backend panel, and the customers can bid the amount. So in the auction bidders, you can check the bidders who have placed the amount for your auction. Like you can check from here, the bidder, the auction which we have added right now is visible here. The highest bidding amount is there which we have added for the auction. And again clicking on this auction, in the completed auction you can check the list of the completed auction. This is visible here which we have right now added, and you can check the details from here of this particular auction. So this is how you can manage your auction and can create it and can make it reflect to your customers as per your requirement. So what are you waiting for? Join the bidding craze on Odoo website auction and empower your bidding journey. Found the video helpful? Do press the like button and share your views in the comment section below. Got a questions or need help? Feel free to contact us at support@webkul.com or raise a ticket at webkul.ubdesk.com. See you all in the upcoming videos. Till then, thanks for watching. Stay tuned.